I kind of struggled with posting my competition video because I really wasn't proud of it. I didn't feel like I did my best. I was definitely super anxious. I flew all the way from Florida to LA to support my friend Miles. And yeah, it was a really good experience. I did a commercial while I was out there for Racks to Riches. Shout out to them. It was just good overall networking, meeting a lot of people, being in the same room as women who enjoy doing the same things that I enjoy doing. So that was fun, but I'll edit it in here so you guys can see it. But I messed up my first trick and my whole performance was like downhill from there. And I say downhill in quotation marks because it really wasn't terrible, but like I am my own worst critic. And so in my opinion, it definitely wasn't my best performance. And I feel like I went out there and I'm not from there, so nobody had ever seen me dance, but I also left feeling like this is really annoying me, so I'm gonna try to untangle it. But yeah, but I left also feeling like nobody had seen me dance. So that was a little bit disappointing, but that definitely wasn't my first competition, nor is it going to be my last. I just really wanted to challenge myself and go out of town, you know, to a different crowd, a different group of people. I have to remind myself that it's okay to be disappointed, you know. Failure is all a part of the journey, but I'm proud of myself for doing it. I overthought the whole thing. I freestyle almost everything that I do when it comes to pole dancing, so I overthought it too much.
I took 2 shots before I got on stage.
I don't really drink anymore, so.
That definitely probably affected me.
There were only 2 people in the crowd, besides like the people from LA that I know. There were only 2 people in the crowd who came specifically for me, like to support me. So that was a little different because I'm used to being in a room full of people who already know me as a performer. But the experience overall was definitely something that I would recommend any dancer, any aerialist to do. The whole experience was amazing. The Pole Olympics is most definitely here to stay. I know that Miles is thinking about doing 1 or 2 of them annually, so definitely head over to Young Pole Masters page for that, or visit at the Pole Olympics on Instagram. I was disappointed in my performance. That's why I struggled to post it, so I figured I would edit it in here so that whoever wanted to see it could see it. But I also wanted to explain why I felt like my performance was so poor. I feel like even my practice runs that I did for that day were better than what I put on for the judges, and that's how I knew that I was really, really nervous. And I even showed the video to a couple of people who have seen me dance before. And one of my close friends told me, she was like, of all the times I've ever seen you dance and perform, I have never seen you dance with your head down. So yeah, after I messed up my first trick, I believe my confidence was just kind of like, And it kind of sucks because like you don't really get any do-overs, but I didn't bomb the performance. I didn't like mess up and then walk off stage. That's not what you do. The show must go on. Fucked up my first trick and I was just like, okay. I didn't execute, I had probably like 4 tricks in my mind that I knew I wanted to do that didn't even come out on stage. But overall, it was a really good experience. That's why I do these types of things, to learn, to grow, to be in bigger rooms. Oh, Diplo was there. That was dope. Shout out to Miles. I don't know who invited him, why he was there. I mean, I know why he was there, but that was pretty cool. I ended up on this story. Yeah. I really should have put some makeup on to film this. My skin looks crazy. But it's okay.
Let's go!